This is the Foucault's Pendulum apparatus. It replicates Foucault's experiment in Paris in the 19th century, where he was checking the effect of the long-term oscillation of a pendulum and finding that it rotated, the plane of the oscillation rotated related to the rotation of the Earth. His pendulum was 28 feet long. This pendulum is a little over a meter long. It consists of a big heavy bob on a very fine wire, 0.3 millimeters in diameter. And there's a device here which centers the pendulum's suspension, and also every half oscillation makes contact with the edge of a little ring, so that energizes an electromagnet underneath here to give the pendulum a little kick to maintain the oscillation, so that the amplitude does not decrease over time. Here at the latitude of Chicago, it takes about 36 hours for the pendulum's plane of oscillation to make a full rotation. So this is a long-term experiment or a display item. As a display item, you can illuminate the inside of the case. A little bit about the construction. The main items here are suspended inside a steel case. There are glass windows on all four sides with a door up the front for access, because drafts make a significant difference to the measurements, and this eliminates drafts sufficiently. There are leveling feet underneath the instrument so that when you start the experiment, you know that you have the pendulum correctly centered and level. On the base, you can see two measuring devices. First of all, a 360-degree scale for measuring the plane of the pendulum in terms of degrees, and also a little black and clear pointer that can be moved. And the way this is used is that the positioning of the scale compared with the room you're in is completely arbitrary. When you start your experiment, you line up the center of the little black pointer with the plane of the swing of the pendulum, and then when you come back later, maybe 4 or 5 hours, maybe the next day, maybe 2 days, you realign the marker and determine the angle through which the pendulum has rotated. One of the features is this knob here. This adjusts the amount of kick that the electromagnet gives to the pendulum each swing, so that the amplitude of the pendulum remains more or less constant. This is an experiment which goes slowly. So you will have to adjust something, then wait 15 minutes, see what the effect of the result was, and maybe readjust it. But once it's adjusted, you shouldn't need any alteration. That's the device. It comes with everything you see here, plus it comes with a full explanation of both how to assemble the pendulum and also the theory of background and how to operate it.